G'day everyone, welcome to another episode of Dingle DIY. Now, today we're doing something a little bit different. I'm helping some family friends with a high school project. Now, they lack the expertise in woodworking, and with all this COVID nonsense going on, it's been a bit tricky for them. So I'm stepping in to give them a helping hand, give the young fella as much experience as I can give him without him losing any fingers. We are building an infinity desk. Basically, that's a reflective surface with some lights in the middle and then a one-way mirror on top. No, and it gives this illusion of like infinite lights that just disappear into a black hole. We're building it out of some old red gum that used to be a different piece of furniture. Hopefully this inspires you to make something cool similar to this. And yeah, hopefully you enjoy. Ripping my heart was so easy, so easy. Launch your assault now, take it easy. Raise your weapon. One word and it's over. Ripping through like a missile, ripping through my heart. Rob me of this love. Alright, pretty stoked with how that turned out. Now, that's the first time I've ever built an infinity desk, and especially the first time I've ever built one with a 16-year-old and his dad. So, all things considered, it went pretty well, and I was really focusing on giving the young fella a lot of experience and letting him do a lot of things. Even if it meant making mistakes, that was okay. That's a part of learning. Now, some things I want to share with you with regards to the LED strips. Now, there are two spacings you need to consider. The first spacing is the space between every individual LED on the whole strip. Now, whatever that measurement is, you want to figure it out and you want to make sure the lights are equal distances from the corner. If you do decide to do the whole building look thing like we did, every time you go around an external corner or around an internal corner, you want your LEDs to be the same distance from that corner in each direction. So in our case, the LEDs were 34 millimeters apart. So that meant we had to work the building dimensions with factors of 17 millimeters. So that way, every side length would work LED spacings basically. So that was our factor. That's one thing you need to consider. The other thing you need to consider is the spacing between the strips, the next strip, depending on how many you want to use, and then the reflective surfaces, top and bottom. If we were working in units of one, say the LED strip was one unit, the gap between that and the next one was one unit, the next strip was one unit, and then the gap between the top and the bottommost strips, the gap between them and the reflective surface was half a unit. That way, by the time that space was reflected, and then, you know, that illusion is repeated, that half is doubled, becomes a whole unit, and then it looks like you have equal spacings between your gaps and your LED strips, especially by the time they've been reflected a whole bunch of times. Now lastly, we used Perspex on the bottom so that we could drill holes through it and run our wiring. Now with those buildings, we drilled holes in the back of them, so we decided on which was going to be the front and the back of the desk so that when you're sitting at the desk, you can't see the holes in the backs of those buildings, and that's where we snaked our LED lights in and out of. Now we also laid those out and then drilled a hole pretty much through the Perspex in the middle of where those buildings were going to sit, so that way we could run the lights out, across, and then back up through a different hole and then wrap around the next building, so on and so forth till it was done. And we also had a building pretty close to the back edge, and then that back edge was also where we ran the perimeter LED strip around the whole cavity of the desk. You just want to be clever with your placement and your holes and things like that, just so that you hide where your wires come in and out of, and it's really going to give you a much neater result. Now lastly was the reflective film. So we just had some regular glass. You can buy reflective film, or you can, it's maybe called one-way film, or you know, one-way mirror film, something along those lines. You can get your hands on it pretty easily. So you basically apply that to the glass on one side, so that way you can see through the glass, but the light inside the desk stays reflected internally. Now we use the same film on the Perspex on the bottom, so reflective side in, so that there's basically two mirrors facing each other. That's what creates the illusion. And then we also just, we put some black vinyl wrap adhesive on the other side of the Perspex, just so that no extra light was coming in, and it really made the mirror effect work a lot better. Now you could use one-way glass, but it's a lot harder to drill holes through that, so that's why we went the Perspex route. All right, that pretty much sums up all the little secrets that we uncovered as we built this, so thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, subscribe. And yeah, if you have any questions, just leave them in the comment section below, and I will get back to you, and we'll see you on the next video.